Hello guys, welcome to yet another video about Starpoint Gemini 3. In this video we're going to show you a little bit more advanced mechanics that exist in this game. So basically it's a combination of movement skills, equipment items, and everything you can do to actually perform a really advanced type of combat, attacking capital ships and performing very hard missions and demanding tasks that exist in the game. So right now I'm going to show you so some basics regarding movement. Is it's really easy to understand how it works. Basically, movement is you can go forward, backwards, left, strafe left, right, go up, go down, use boost. So boost is a temporary boost, temporary increase of your speed. It drains your boost energy. You can of course upgrade it by installing appropriate modules to your ship. But boost is mostly useful in combination with cut engines mode. That mode is the one you actually cut power to your engines, and you use inertia as a sole impulse for moving. While in cut engine mode, you can use the boost to propel yourself in a certain direction. It allows for a very very quick change of direction and your speed, so you can evade enemy missiles fire, especially coming from capital ships that have a lot of turrets. So it's useful to understand and to practice how that works. Anyway, we're going to show you now a combat that's actually quite advanced combat. We're going to go straight into enemy territory. So enemy stations, enemy capital ships, enemy freighters, enemy protection ships, everything. It's a very demanding combat, but we're going to show you how it works if you combine all the items, your upgrade skills, switching your weapons in mid-combat, using cut engines to evading attacks, using different missiles, torpedoes, and everything you have at your disposal. The ship we're going to use in that combat is going to be quite advanced one, already fully upgraded and loaded with weapons and items. So, but we wanted to show you how it can work and to what extent you can upgrade your skills in ships and its abilities in combat. And here we are, right in the middle of the enemy territory. So we are close to the enemy space station, and we are surrounded with enemy ships, as you notice. And this is a enemy capital ship, freight liner. So this is basically our target. This is what we came here for. So we want to destroy as many of these freight ships as possible. There are a lot of them here because this is a trade station of our enemies, and the traffic of cargo ships will be quite high here. However, they will be defended, and they will also call for other ships to help them if they're attacked, as you see. Now, every capital ship has weak points. So what we're doing is we're sub-targeting weak points on every targeted capital ship. That's the fastest way to destroy them. It's not the only way that you can destroy them even without them, but it's going to be a very hard and long effort to do that. So right now we just switched to a weapon with a very high rate of fire. That's a machine gun type of weapon. Also, what you're going to notice is that we are constantly switching between weapons in this combat. So we have one very very powerful close range weapon, and one fast, very very fast long range weapon. So we're gonna switch between them as needed during this battle. And also, as you notice, we just used one of our booster items, shield booster, to enhance our shields. And what we are doing now is we just fired a torpedo against the capital ship. Torpedoes are incredibly powerful missiles, very slow but powerful missiles, specialized to destroy capital ships. So always bear in mind you should have them in your inventory when you're attacking your capital ships. Also, we're gonna make another run for this freighter. So we're basically doing hit and run tactics. We deal as much damage as we can, fire a torpedo, destroy, deal as much damage as possible to the weak point that's adjacent to our firing arc, and then we simply bail out of the battle, take care of a few incoming escort ships, and then get back to destroying the capital ship. So that's the basically in a combat such as this, you're supposed to be very 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 fast and very maneuver very very dynamically to avoid incoming fire and to deal as much damage as possible. We're gonna target his weak points again, and he's down. Yeah, one ship down. But as you see, the number of enemies is now increasing. We just launched another equipment. It's a decoy equipment that's supposed to lure enemy missiles away from you. But as capital ships are being attacked, they are calling for reinforcements, and ships protecting station and their freighters will be coming more and more. So the area will become increasingly hostile, and you will really need to do everything you can to just avoid damage. So another decoy going here, and as you notice, we're now in cut engines mode. So what we do here, we are using cut engines and boost to simply use the inertia to maintain our course and our heading, and then use the boost option to propel the ship in a specific direction. So that is definitely the fastest possible way to very abruptly change direction and do very very dynamic maneuvers to that allows you to position yourself behind the weak point on a capital ship you want to fire, and to also avoid damage from the enemies, multiple enemies or capital ship. So bear in mind, this capital ship is works like a standard capital ship, but it's a non-combat capital ship. It's a freight liner. So the amount of damage this freight liner can deal against you is quite low, but it has some hit points that need some time to be destroyed. However, if you encounter enemy combat capital ship, the basic mechanics you need to do is going to be the same, but you will definitely you will receive a very heavy enemy fire from that capital ship, because combat capital ships are heavily armed, and they alone can deal huge amounts of damage. So you're gonna have to be extra careful. Just basically use the cut engines, change direction as much as possible, do not be in their line of sight, avoid their missiles. You can destroy their missiles by simply shooting at them when they're incoming. You can divert them using decoys, and you can also use your dumbfire missiles that have a spread and blast radius to destroy and disperse groups of enemy ships. As I said before, against capital ships, torpedoes are your best bet. And also, don't be left without shield boosters, repair nanobots, or automated defense drones, or any other types of equipment that can greatly help you in combat such as this. Also, beware that you are constantly reminded to upgrade your ship. So better wings, better hull, more durable hull, better shield, a larger energy pool for weapons, and management of your skills is also very important if you want to have a overall very powerful setup of a ship to engage in combats such as this one. Well, we now came to the much more calm part of space, but this is mostly what I wanted to show you in this video. So hopefully you'll be successful, and with a little bit of practice, you'll very soon be at the level of destructive power that we just shown you in this video.